The COP26 climate conference, held in Glasgow in the UK, has come to an end. Some people are celebrating its successes, others lamenting its failures. But let's take a look at what was actually discussed.
Hearing no objections, it is so decided.
It may not look like it, but I'm in London, the UK's capital city. This is Hampstead Heath, a wild park just a few miles from the city centre. It's protected land, which means that no one can build on it. And that's really important for the environment, for the animals, the plants and the insects that live here to have a breath of fresh air.
The COP26 climate conference was also trying to protect the environment in order to reduce the effects of climate change.
At the end of the conference, a new global agreement was made called the Glasgow Climate Pact. It covered lots of areas, including coal, cars, cash, and trees. Trees absorb carbon dioxide, and when they're cut down, that's released back into the atmosphere, which contributes to global warming. Now, more than 100 countries have agreed to stop cutting down trees by 2030 and plant new ones instead. That includes Brazil, home to the Amazon, the world's largest tropical rainforest. Just outside the park, most of these cars run on fossil fuels, which release greenhouse gases. Now a group of countries and car manufacturers have agreed to stop selling new cars that run on fossil fuels by 2040 or even earlier. But the largest car markets in the world, China and the US, as well as some of the largest car manufacturers, did not sign. In a climate deal made 12 years ago, higher income countries promised to raise $100 billion each year to help lower income countries deal with the effects of climate change, like flooding and wildfires. But they didn't meet that target, and there was a lot of anger about it ahead of this year's talks. Now they've got until 2025 to raise the same amount each year. We'll have to wait and see if they deliver. Coal is the single biggest contributor to climate change, and the Glasgow Climate Pact is the first deal of its kind to try to reduce its use. But after talking about phasing coal out, India and China changed the wording of the deal to phasing coal down, and that was disappointing for many. To reduce the effects of climate change, global warming needs to be kept to 1.5 degrees Celsius. Now, with the current agreement, it's set to rise to 2.4 degrees, and that means that the world will continue to suffer the impact of climate change.
To get all the latest news and videos on trending topics, just subscribe to our YouTube channel here.